सत्यम वदा धर्माचर सत्यमेव जयते। गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, सुप्रभात। आई एम विपुल कुमार, वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू टुडेज न्यूज डेस्क ऑन इनकम टैक्स, जीएसटी एंड कॉर्पोरेट लॉज। लेट्स स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द इनकम टैक्स। मद्रास हाई कोर्ट जस्टिफाइड सेक्शन 40A सबसेक्शन 3 दिस अलाउंसेज एज एसएससी मेकिंग cash payment though despite having banking facilities. In this case, Madras High Court held that where SEC company made cash payment for purpose of acquiring right to screen movies in theaters to various parties running into lakhs of the rupees, though pay was identifiable, but since in spite of availability of the banking facilities, SEC had been regularly effecting cash payment, said payment were to be disallowed in terms of section 40A subsection 3, read with rule 6DD. Madras High Court ने इस केस में cash payments को disallowance किया है, जो आपके certain limit 10,000 से ऊपर per day per पार्टी दिया हुआ है, अगर उसको करते हैं तो डिसलाउंसेस है। और अगर बैंकिंग फैसिलिटीज है आपके पास तो आपको बैंकिंग फैसिलिटी यूज करना है। अगर बैंकिंग फैसिलिटी आप इसके यूज किए बिना आप इसको करते हैं एक लिमिट से ज्यादा पर डे, तो आपको डिसलाउंस होती है। तो मद्रास हाई कोर्ट ने इसको जस्टिफाइड किया है डिसलाउंसेस को इस केस के अंदर। सेकेंड, मुंबई ट्राइब्यूनल ब्रॉट फॉरवर्ड short-term capital loss not to be set off against exempt capital gain, ITAT allowed carry forward of losses. In this case, Mumbai Tribunal held that where SEC and FII based in Mauritius had claimed the short-term and long-term gains arising in its hands from transfer of securities in Indian market as exempt under Article 13 of the Double Taxation Avoidance Agreement, which was allowed accordingly, assessing officer in concluding that the short-term and long-term capital gain earned by the SEC from transfer of securities in India during the year under consideration were to be adjusted against the short-term capital loss brought forward by the assessee from the earlier years, and thus only the balance amount of the short-term capital loss was to be carried forward to the subsequent year, and consequently assessee had rightly carried forward brought forward short-term capital loss of the previous year to the subsequent year. In this case, Mumbai Tribunal held that brought forward जो short term capital loss है, जो set off नहीं किया जा सकता है exempt capital gain से, तो ITATA ने उसको allowed किया carry forward of the losses. Next case, Supreme Court ने decide किया है a special leave petition granted against ruling deleting section 271D penalty as depositor were from rural area having no banking facilities. So a special leave petition against High Court decision holding that where the SEC company avail cash deposit from depositors in rural areas in view of non-availability of adequate banking facilities, section 271D penalty need not be imposed, was to be granted. तो इस केस के अंदर स्पेशल लीव पेटिशन ग्रांट किया गया है अगेंस्ट रूलिंग एक है 271D पेनल्टी को डिलीट करने का एज डिपॉजिटर, क्योंकि वो रूरल एरिया में है जहां बैंकिंग फैसिलिटी नहीं है, तो 271D का जो कैश डिपॉजिट का होता था सेक्शन का वायलेशन में पेनल्टी को उसने डिलीट करने की बात कही सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने और SLP ग्रांट किया। नेक्स्ट केस, कटक ट्राइब्यूनल एग्जिम्पशन फॉर मेडिकल अलाउंसेस कुडेंट बी अलाउड इफ एम्प्लॉय डिडंट सबमिट प्रूफ टू इनकरिंग मेडिकल एक्सपेंडिचर वेयर देयर वाज नो प्रूफ ऑफ द मेडिकल एक्सपेंडिचर इनकर्ड बाय द एम्प्लॉयज एंड एसएससी एम्प्लॉयर also could not substantiate that employee had spent allowances received by them for intended purpose, fixed medical allowance given by the employer was taxable as salary income. तो इस केस में कटक ट्राइब्यूनल ने जो एजम्पशन मेडिकल अलाउंस में देते हैं वो अलाउड नहीं होगा अगर इम्प्लॉई जो है प्रूफ है जो मेडिकल एक्सपेंडिचर का जो इंक्वायर किया उसका प्रूफ अगर सबमिट नहीं करता है तो एजम्पशन अलाउड नहीं होगा इस केस के अंदर. जीएसटी अब नाउ स्टार्ट वी जीएसटी अमेंडमेंट. Bombay High Court bank guarantee submitted for release of the detained goods to be refunded when SSE deposited amount in excess of the dues. अगर excess dues से excess अगर deposit कर दिया SSE ने तो bank guarantee जो submit किया गया था detained goods के लिए वो उसको refund करना का order इसमें आया. So where the competent authority had detained goods of the SSE and subsequently released the same on SSE furnishing bank guarantee, and SSE after release of the goods approach competent authority not to encash bank guarantee as he could file appeal under section 112 and had already deposited required fee, but authority in cash all bank guarantees since amount linked with the authority was already in excess of dues payable by SSE. Authority should refund amount covered by all bank guarantee with interest and SSE should furnish fresh bank guarantee with nationalized bank. Next case. Appellant advance authority ruling Maharashtra construction of the breakwater wall to protect jetty is not a plant and machinery ITC is not available. Held in this ruling appellant company is engaged in the regasification of LNG which reaches to the plant through jetty. It is not eligible to avail input tax credit of the tax rate paid to the supplier of the goods and services on construction of the breakwater wall, which is an important and integral part of the existing jetty. Since breakwater wall does not remotely fall under the plant and machinery or apparatus or equipment in terms of the section 17. In this case, Kokan LNG Private Limited in 2019 cases, AAR Maharashtra affirmed. Next ruling, advance authority ruling, Karnataka. Property tax and other statutory levies not deductible from the value of renting of the immovable property. In this ruling, AAR Karnataka held that where the SSE was engage in the business of the renting of the commercial property on monthly rent and allied business SSE could not deduct property taxes and other statutory dues for the purpose of arriving at value of the rental income, and SSE was entitled to exemption of the tax under general exemption of the 20 lakhs subject to the condition that its annual turnover which included monthly rent and notional interest on security deposit by tenant if it influences value of the supply. Did not exceed threshold limit. So इस केस में हमने देखा कि प्रॉपर्टी टैक्स और अदर स्टेचुरी लेवीज है उसको डिडक्ट नहीं करेंगे वैल्यू ऑफ द रेंटिंग जो है रेंट का इमोबल प्रॉपर्टी के रेंटिंग वैल्यू से उसको डिडक्ट नहीं करेंगे. नेक्स्ट सीबीआईसी नोटिफिकेशन ऑन 1st अक्टूबर वन टाइम रिलैक्सेशन ग्रांटेड इन केस ऑफ द नॉन इश्यूएंस ऑफ द इनवॉइस ड्यूरिंग अक्टूबर 2020. The government has provided relaxation to registered person from requirement to generate invoice reference number IRN in respect of the invoices issued during the period from 1st October 2020 to 31st October 2020. In these cases, IRN, jo invoice reference number for such invoice can be generated within 30 days from the date of the invoice. This one-time relaxation is only up to 31st October 2020, and after this period, the invoice without IRN shall not be treated as a valid invoice. इस सर्कुलर में 1 month का relaxation और दे दिया गया पूरे अक्टूबर तक का जो non-issuance of invoice के रिगार्डिंग जो IRN reference number आपको generate करना था उसके रिगार्डिंग. Now we cover amendment or an updates in company law. Kerala High Court writ petition challenging order of the ROC to furnish document for investigation was rejected. So in this case, where the pursuant to the order of the NCLT register of the companies had issued order requiring company of which petitioner was directed to furnish copies of the certain document for purpose of the investigation proposed under section 210 and petitioner preferred appeal before the NCLAT against order of the NCLT writ petition filed to quash order of the registrar of the company was disposed of permitting petitioner to pursue all his contention before NCLAT. तो केरला हाई कोर्ट ने रीट पेटिशन जो चैलेंजिंग ऑर्डर ऑफ द आरओसी जो ऑर्डर को चैलेंज कर रहा था जो फर्निश डॉक्यूमेंट फॉर इन्वेस्टिगेशन उसको रिजेक्ट किया. जनरल सर्कुलर इशूड बाय द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ कॉर्पोरेट अफेयर्स 35/1/2020 29 सितंबर को. इन दिस सर्कुलर एमसीए एक्सटेंड लेट डेट ऑफ द फाइलिंग last date of the filing of the various IEPF e-forms. The MCA extend the company fresh start scheme 2020 till 31st December 2020. Necessary relaxation in so far as filing on the various IEPS PF e-form IEPF 1, 1A, 2, 3, 4, 7 and e-verification of the claims filed in e-form IEPF 5 without additional fees till 31st December 2020 has also been provided in the said circular. The stakeholder may plan other concomitant action accordingly, MCA circular said in this circular. That we are cover all updates on the last day. Till last Friday or Saturday. So as per request of our audience, they insist to at least try to give your news coverage in Hindi also. So we are trying to at least heading should be read out in Hindi or in understandable language. So we are trying for that. Thank you so much for watching our news desk on regular basis. Thank you so much.